Our first venture into renewables at Glensaugh was the construction of a wind turbine in 2010, which you can just see the blades of beyond the trees. More recently, in 2014, we put an array, a 70 kilowatt array of solar panels on the roof of the animal house, which you can see in the foreground here. The solar panels were a great fit with the animal house because within that building is a lot of refrigeration equipment. So on hot sunny days when the refrigeration equipment is working hard, so are the solar panels. And we found that our overall electricity cost on the farm dropped by about 50% after we put the panels in. The great thing about solar panels on farms is that most farms have got sheds, so lots of roof space. Even better if the roofs are facing south. But what we're also looking at Glensaugh is the possibility of putting a solar panel array in one of our fields. And that, of course, could go on to less productive land and need not take up a great deal of space. So this is technology that can be adopted by many farms, if not all. But there is a problem with solar, and that is intermittency of supply. The sun's shining today, but we're about to go into winter, so we won't have much solar power generated for the next 4 or 5 months. They generate a massive amount of power in the spring and early summer. Wind is a good technology to bring into the mix because sometimes it's windy, and particularly in winter when the sun isn't shining much, we tend to have more wind. Having different technologies in the mix, therefore, in part gets us around the intermittency problem, but not completely, because quite often we have too much sunlight and or too much wind. So having a technology whereby we can store that energy for future use would allow us to smooth out the intermittency generation problem. The technology that we would like to introduce to Glensaugh to overcome the intermittency problem is hydrogen generation. So if we can use the excess power to generate hydrogen and store it, then that hydrogen can be released, in other words, burned, to power vehicles, to heat homes, or indeed to generate more electricity, which could be fed back into the national grid.